Welcome to Hide and Seek TV. It's your boy Hide and Seek, and I'm back again. About to do a very deep breakdown, and about to be this right here is live news report for the Holy Kingdom of Judah. And I'm actually going to be showing a lot of things that's going on symbolically that led up to this moment, and you know, just the whole theme of everything, why everything had to happen in the way it's happening, and all the symbology. In the midst of everybody focusing on Diddy's baby oil, you know, or Kamala, or Trump, etc., or all the other staged events, you know what I'm saying? You know, everything's all coming together. Even the situation that happened today with the, what was it, the Marcellus Williams with the lethal injection, you know, and his last words was all praise be to Allah. And, you know, the whole theme and Exodus 3:14, you know, as it's written, and the Father says he's the I am that I am. So that's why you see a lot of the Williams situations going on right now, because that's just the will of the I am. So you got Young Thug in jail, you know, his name is Williams. You got Pooh Shiesty in jail, his name is Williams. You see, I mean, I can go on and on. So that whole theme, you know, with the Marcellus on Williams with the lethal injection, the all praise be to Allah. You know, that all that stuff just all going into the Christ line. And they already know that the gathering is happening. So, you know, real people say we signing a petition. But basically the governmental powers, they use those events and those Masonic staged events to be like, okay, you know, y'all got real people who want to support you. But at the end of the day, we pull the string, because they know that the gathering is happening with the Messiah and his saints upon the earth. So I'm going to delve deeper into this right here, and I'm going to play a clip from the news report, and I'm going to chime on in.
September 23rd.
Now, see right here, it's very important. Let me go back. So you see right there, you have, you know, the Lewis key, you know, and the scepter, the rod. So you understand the Lewis key. You know what they like to call the Ankh in pagan Egypt, but it's really the Alpha and Omega, Lewis, you know, the key of David. So, and the reason why I'm mentioning the Lewis, for those who don't understand, when you understand the whole theme of Hallelujah, Halle means to praise, Lewis, eternal Yah. So, hint the whole theme, the whole aspect of the whole theme of the Messiah holding the key. And then you got the scepter. So, it's all showing how the tribe knows that the Messiah rises out of the holy tribe of Judah, you know, and that he will hold the rod, and that he will hold the Lewis key. So that's just showing that the power is in the midst, you know, the Messiah being in the midst, when you see the scepter and the Lewis key. All of this stuff is all coming together, and it's all about who got the eyes to see and ears to hear. I've been saying this is going to happen for the past what, four years now, right? 2021, going on three, almost 4 years. I've been saying this stuff was going to start happening, you know? So this stuff is serious, and the Exodus is unraveling. So let's play the clip and chime on in.
September
20th. So you understand that right there, too, is very important. Because when you understand the whole theme of the Chief of Chiefs in the royal blue, you know, that goes into the law, the order. And when you understand that pinky that's being shown, the pinky goes into the whole thing. You know that the hand of God, the hand of the I am, the pinky finger, even though that's the weakest finger, you know, you remove the pinky, the whole hand can't function. So you see the whole theme is just symbolic of showing that the hand of God, even the pinky finger, is stronger than the Antichrist government that we're up against. And that we're, you know, that we're bringing down through law and order. That's why you see the whole theme, just the image. You know, this is not the physical look of Melchizedek, but just a example, you know, of Melchizedek. You see how they have the pinky finger, because the Melchizedek, remember, he was the during the time of Abraham, the high priest of the bread and wine. He was the Christ figure during the time of Abraham that Abraham was dealing with. You know, the Messiah. You know, in that sense of that time, how God would interact with Abraham through Melchizedek. So this is very important to understand what's going on here. You know, it's not a game. This stuff is real, you know. So let's delve deeper into it.
3rd, 2024. The Holy Kingdom of Judah, Tribal Council of Chiefs.
See that? The chiefs, and then the chief of chief in the midst.
The governing body of the tribe of Judah met with policymakers to discuss pressing issues, which included restoration of the Holy Kingdom of Judah and what is now being called the Second Exodus.
You see that? Right in Wichita, Kansas, like I've been saying for the last 4 years, how important understanding what Kansas represents. So you see that they said they met up with the policymakers to discuss the Exodus. So let's talk about that, because the whole thing, obviously, to understand what's going on, people have to learn the ways of the Lord. You see what I mean? So the whole meeting and gathering was to understand about gaining the whole thing within Wichita, because like I explained before, when you understand Kansas, you know, it's very important, because when you understand Kansas, you know, Kansas area code is 316, hint John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he sent his only begotten son. So hint the 316 to John 3:16. When you understand Kansas, remember on the Wizard of Oz was very important, because remember through Kansas, they made it to Emerald City. And Emerald City is just the Holy Kingdom of Judah, the Holy Kingdom of Heaven. So when you understand, you know, as it's written in Revelation 4:3, that Judah would be as the color of the emerald. So that's why you have the Emerald City. So that's why through Kansas, they made it through Emerald City. Remember, she went through the tornado because to get to Kansas, to get from Kansas to Emerald City. Because when you understand that tornado is very important, because that tornado goes into Ezekiel 1:4 for the Messiah is revealed via the whirlwind. That's why Kansas is in Tornado Alley, dealing with the winds. Remember, as it's written, that the Messiah shall gather up in Zechariah 2:6, that he would gather up the four winds of heaven, which is the children of God, you know, the Judahites, the Israelites. Zechariah 2:6, he would gather up the four winds of heaven. So you see that whole theme of the library had to happen. That's why there's a discussion about gaining a library, because when you understand the library, that all goes into the whole aspect of the education that's going to happen in the process of the time of preparing for the Exodus. People are going to be educated. So that's why they shut that library down in 2018. I'll get into all of that in a minute. But it's very important to know what's going on, because as it's written, you know, as in Isaiah 2:3, and many people shall go and say, come ye and let us go to the mountain of the Lord, to the house of the God of Jacob, and he will teach us of his ways, and we will walk in his path, for out of Zion shall go forth the law and the word of the Lord from Jerusalem. So you understand, this all goes to the whole time when the Exodus fulfills and people are going to start learning, you know, the ways of the Lord, you know, within the land of what they call Egypt, but it's really Zion, which I'll get into in a minute. But when you understand all of that right there, that all goes into the whole theme of preparing, the preparation. So people are going to start learning who they are, you know, and so forth. You know, that's why the library is the target. So you see how all this stuff is all coming together. And the policymakers, so things going to start going from being called blacks, N-words, African-American, all bywords, and people are going to be called Judahites and who they really are, Judahites. You know, none of that white, black talk, you know. So-called whites, you know, the Gentiles and so forth. People are going to be called who they really are, and people are grafting into the Holy Kingdom of Judah. So how they try to keep everything separated, but everybody stand a chance, you know, if you humble your heart and, you know, and seek the Lord and know that he's in the flesh. And this is what prophecy said will happen. You know, I'm not just sitting here just talking. Even the mayor even said that they know who he is. And that they are agreeing with these methods to restore Judah. You know, that all goes into when you understand that's why they gave you King Kong versus Godzilla. Remember how they were working together to bring down the Mecha Godzilla? Because it's not in the sense of really working together, but in the way that the law going to flow from Zion and that the Exodus is going to fulfill. As it's written, every knee must bow, every tongue must confess. So that's why Godzilla looked like he was helping King Kong. But in reality, it was just preparing Kong to get that throne. You kind of see what I mean? Because as it's written, the meek shall inherit the earth. you know, and that's the Messiah's mission, you know, to give what? To gain the kingdom, gain the earth back, and give it to his people. That's what it's all about. So that's why you see, even back in the 1950s, because that's how blasphemy works, you know, they already know what's going to happen. That's why you had Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis doing the library comedy sketch, you know. So you see, that's why Barack Obama, the Antichrist, had to have his libraries, because the library goes into the lies of Barry. The lies of what? The lies of Barack. Barry. Barack. Remember, his nickname is Barry. So, you know, the whole theme is, as it's written, what they call, they like to call evil good and good evil. And as it's written, you know, the darkness shall be reproved. You know, the Messiah shall cast down the what? The Antichrist lies. So what's the better way to do it than in a library? You know, bringing truth and restoring people to know who Judah really is, who the kingdom really is. That's why Trump already said that he's going to, you know, shut down the Department of Education and move education back to the states, because they already know what's coming. That's why he said, I'm going to do the largest deportation ever in the history of the United States, because that all goes to, they already know the Exodus is going to fulfill. That's why he said, those children want to go home. What about the children? What about the mothers? What about the children? Those children want to go home, you know. It's all about who got the eyes to see and ears to hear and who knows what's really going on all these years. You know, that's why I was showing y'all the Wizard of Oz, which I already kind of elaborated on. But as it's written in scriptures, in Acts 1:11, which I'm going to break all this down right quick, in Acts 1:11, which also said, ye men of Galilee, why stand ye gazing up into heaven? This same Yahushua, which is taken up from you into heaven, shall so come in like manner as ye have seen him go into heaven. Meaning he was going to be a man. That's why, you remember, I'm going to break all this down. Remember I said he shut the library down in 2018. So I'm going to explain this stuff right quick to you guys. I'm going to let it play. You know what I mean? But as you can see, Killmonger, you see, they didn't want him in flesh. They rather him be dead on earth, you know what I mean? Nobody know who he really was. Remember, they was trying to keep him. You are black operative Killmonger. That's who you are, you know? Keep him in black identity and so forth. But you see how they had him in the astral plane, because that's how they want to keep, you know, the Messiah. He's always in heaven, you know what I mean? The Father and the Son and Holy Spirit are always in heaven on the throne. But at the same time, too, you know, he presents himself in a way that we can deal with him in flesh. So he's going to be a man. As it's written in Isaiah 53, you know, he was going to be comely. You know, no, he was going to be a person who people is not going to want to approach. Meaning that, you know, you're going to think, if you so, you're the king, you're the God, then why are you an average looking man? You kind of see what I mean? So that's why you see our Killmonger was in the astral plane, because they want to keep him, you know, in that realm, in a way, if you kind of see what I mean. They want to keep the Messiah just in the realm of the spirit, which he's always in spirit, like I said, but they don't want people to understand that he was going to be a man to deliver us back. As it's written, he was going to deliver us back in Isaiah 19:20, that God was going to send a Savior who was going to deliver us, a great one, and deliver us back into our land, away from our oppressors. But they don't want people knowing that. They want to keep him in the astral plane, which I'll get into in a minute, but just listen to how she talks. Hear what she say.
Real, did you? We're more alike than you think, too.
I'm not.
He said, we're more alike than you think. We think, listen.
Like than you think, too.
I'm nothing like you. You took it for yourself, then destroyed the rest.
You see, you took it for yourself and destroyed the rest, because they already know he's coming to re-educate the people. And what he's going to do, he's going to gain his earth back, gain his altars back, gain the kingdom back. And what? Restore his kingdom and give it to his people. Those Freemasons, those Masonic devils do not want that. You know? In reality. You kind of see what I mean? They know that this is their last time to, you know, have some kind of freedom in a way, per se. That's why they do that, give me liberty, give me death. Why you think a lot of celebrities are dropping like flies? Give me liberty or give me death. They rather be given death than, you know, be under the law that's coming. and be under the re-education that's coming. They ready to die off because as it's written in Revelation 6:16, they're going to run for the hills, you know, because they know people are going to start finding out the truth. They're going to have shame. They're going to run from the hills, go to their bunkers, as it's written, you know.
Unworthy king.
She said, you are unworthy. She actually called him an unworthy king.
Afraid of being replaced.
Afraid of being replaced, you know.
Just a coward,
you know. You see how they talk to him, man. So as it's written in the scriptures in Genesis 49:10, the scepter shall not depart from Judah, nor a lawgiver from between his feet, until Shiloh comes, and unto him shall the gathering of the people be. So even when you understand how you, when you go into the translations and you translate the Shiloh, it's Shiloh. It's all in our face. Even when you take the L-O-I and the S, that's Lewis within Shiloh. So it's all about knowing how the name works, all about knowing the name that it be revealed as is written in Isaiah 52:5-6. And that day my people shall know my name because they blaspheme it all day long. As it's written in John 1:14, and the word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. You know, as it's written, Zechariah 6:12, and speak unto him, saying, thus speaketh the Lord of hosts, saying, behold, the man whose name is Branch, and he shall grow up out of his place, and he shall build the temple of the Lord. Let's delve even further into this. So that's going to how he was going to return, as it's written in Matthew 24:32. Now learn a parable of the fig tree. When his branch is yet tender and putteth forth leaves, ye know that the summer is nigh. So let's see why it mentions the summer. You will know that the... Let's go. Let's read it again. I don't want to just brush through this. So his branch is yet tender and putteth forth leaves, and ye know that the summer is nigh. So what is the branch? Let's go into Zechariah 6:12. Let me go back to that. And speak unto him, saying, thus speaketh the Lord of hosts, saying, behold, the man whose name is the branch, he shall grow up out of his place, and he shall build the temple of the Lord. So let's go into that whole thing where I said that the summer is nigh. So as it's written, and there appeared a great wonder in heaven, a woman clothed with the sun and moon under her feet, and upon her head a crown of 12 stars. And she being with child, travailing in birth and pain to be delivered. And there appeared another wonder in heaven, and behold, a great red dragon, having 7 heads, 10 horns, 7 crowns upon his head. And his tail drew the third part of the stars of heaven, and did cast them to the earth. And the dragon stood before the woman which was ready to be delivered, for to devour her child as soon as it was born. And she brought forth a man who was to rule all nations with a rod of iron. And her child was caught up unto God and to his throne. So you see that the woman which is ready to be delivered. So you see how it says that the dragon sought to destroy him. So the 7 heads, 10 horns, 7 crowns. So the 7 times the 10 is the 70s. So all this goes into the governmental powers. Let's delve deeper into this, man. So yeah, that going to the 70s. So you know the 7 crowns goes into the 7th month. So let's delve into that, because as it's written, in that day there should be an altar to the Lord in the midst of the land of Egypt, and a pillar at the border thereof to the Lord, and there should be for a sign and for a witness unto the Lord of hosts, which are a shadow of things to come, but the body is of Christ. The top of the altar is measured at 76 degrees, and it foreshadows the kingdom to come. So obviously, the 7 heads, 10 horns, 7 crowns, like I was saying, the 7 crowns is the 7th month. So hint, the altar stands 5,776 inches. That's why I say it should be a witness unto the Lord of hosts. Because a host is a body. So the Lord of hosts, the Lord coming into a body. So that's why they stand 5,776 inches with 144,000 casing stones for the 144K that would stand upon the altars with the Lamb of God, as it's written in Revelation 14:1, and the 5,776 inches. Because the 5 go for the 5th day, the first 7 goes for the 7th month, and then the 76 for the 1976 birth year. So July 5th, 1976, That's why July 4th, they shoot up their fireworks to heaven, mocking, saying they got their liberty, give them liberty or give them death. They want their independence from God. That's why they wanted to do, that's why they had to do all that Revolutionary War from England. Remember that England goes through a monarchy, patriarchy system with the father to the son, inheriting the royalty, inheriting leadership from the father. So that's why they had the names Williams and the Lewises and so forth, because they basically, America said they want to be a democracy. You know, democracy just means demon possession. So they want to be liberated from being under the sun's rulership is what they basically were saying, you know. So that's how it all goes down. You know, that's why it's unparalleled to know what's going on. Even when you spell Jerusalem, when these Masons made this America, this USA, they made a false Jerusalem. That's why a lot of states, you have Salem everywhere, you know. So when you understand Jerusalem, J-E-R-U-S-A-L-E-M, come on, man. So that's what it's all understanding about what's going on. That's why I said the dragon tried to slay the woman, slay the child of the woman before he was born, because 1973, they was legalizing abortion. Condom commercials in 75 and feminism and so forth. That's why they had that show where Lewis was one of the main characters. The actor name was Lewis, and they used to bully him. And, you know, it was called Welcome Back, Cotter. And, you know, they say welcome back, you know, to that same old place that you laughed about. You know, because that laughing about, you know, it's just written in Proverbs 1, you know, 25 through 28. You know, the father said that he would laugh at them in their calamity because they mock him. You know, that's what the son said. He's going to laugh at them because they mock him. So he gets to laugh, last laugh in the end. You know, they blaspheme his name all day long. So when you translate praise to the Lord, it becomes Lewis Eternal. So that's the Messiah's name, the Carol Lewis Williams II. When you understand that Carol, you know, the word car, you know, the word Christ, the name Christ, just means the christening, the anointing, you know, it derives from Karas. And Karas just means the anointed Messiah. So, you know, the car goes into the whole theme of having a body, you know, an incarnation. So that's why they like to, that's why they changed the automobile to a car, you know. So when you understand cars, that's why they give you a wheel, you know what I mean? They give you a radio, you know. They put their own, they like to blast their own, you know, their own music, their own tuning, their own frequencies, etc. within your car to corrupt the car. You listen to your own frequencies, your own radio station. You know, you got your wheel directing yourself. You got your own gear, your own shift. You go your way and you stay in your lane. You know, notice the right lane is the slow lane and the left lane is the fast lane, because they want you on that left hand side. You know, with all the goats, you know, as it's written, the goats will be on my left and my sheep on my right. So they want you with the rebellious goats in the fast lane, do what you want to do. They don't want you following the steps of the Lord. So all that stuff goes into this, you know. They already know that the Messiah is in the midst. There's no way around none of this, man. It's all about who got the eyes to see and ears to hear. So let's delve even deeper into this. Let's hear this devil talk. Don't wanna hear about it. See, they don't want to hear about it. The word of God, the name is being revealed. The word of God is spreading, the Messiah being revealed. Every single one's got a story to tell. Every single one got a story to tell. The saints are spreading the name. People are waking up. Everyone knows about it. See, everybody knows about it. Those devils blaspheme the holy name. That's why I put it all in the video, the comment section below, where I break down why Masons, once they hit Mark 11 degree, in the 11th degree, they become a Lewis. I put all that in the comment section below, you know, because they got to come and blaspheme the name. But let's hear this. From the Queen of England to the Hounds of Hell. So you hear that. From the Queen of England to the Hounds of Hell, everybody know about it. So you understand that Queen of England to the Hound of Hell, because Queen of England just basically sent Mother Babylon, and then the Hounds of Hell, obviously those demons that come out that hell pit, you know. Here it is. Here, I'm going to Wichita. Let's talk about it. I'm not just talking. I'm going to Wichita. Far from this opera forevermore. I'm going to work the straw. Make the sweat drip out of every pore. Then you got that big behemoth trying to block the altar. So he said, I'm going to Wichita and I'm going to work the straw, because you know that war elephant, that big behemoth demon, loves to help build in war against the kingdom. You kind of see what I mean? The big gluttonous demon behemoth, you know? So you see all that stuff is all coming together. That's why on the Lion King, remember Scar, remember Mufasa said, don't go to Elephant Graveyard, Simba. And he's like, why? He was like, because, you know, you go over there, you know, you don't need to go there. Remember, Scar took him anyway, because Scar just represents the Messiah who was scarred for our sins. And Mufasa just represents Lucifer, Obama. That's why Obama's zodiac is the Leo, because he's the false lion. He's Satan, the lion seeking whom he may devour. It's all in your face, man. It's not that hard to understand. That's why you see Lucifer, a.k.a. Mufasa, notice right around the time of all this coming together with the meeting for the library to teach and the meeting for that just went down September 23rd. Notice James Earl Jones, who played Mufasa, had to die off because all of those antichrists are falling down. He was Mufasa. So you see how all this stuff, remember, as soon as he fell on the movie, Mufasa fell down. You remember Scar got that throne, which I'm going to get into all of this. But you see that big behemoth devil, you know, he want to block that altar. So you heard the guy say, I'm going to Wichita, and he going to work the straw, because that's what those masons do. They work 7 day shift, night shift. They never stop working, you know, to try to stop heaven from getting to what's got to fulfill. Here he said, I'm going to Wichita, and I'm bleeding right before the Lord. They know he's there. You know, people who don't want to believe it, man, as it's written, repent. Remember, therefore, how thou hast received and heard, and how fast and repent. If therefore thou should not watch, I will come on thee as a thief, and thou should not know what hour I will come upon thee. That's why it says he come as a thief in the night. He only come as a thief in the night to those who not watching and knowing what's going on. Because the day of the Lord is near. We already see the solar eclipse. We already seen all of this. I didn't show what happened May 14th. With the meeting in Wichita, I just showed what's happening September 23rd, you know, the solar eclipse, etc. You know, Beetlejuice, all of these things has been signs, and they just working, focusing on Diddy with the baby oil. When that whole time Diddy dealing with the baby oil, all that stuff just goes into anyway, the oil just goes into that anointing, the gathering, and the dildos just goes into the rod, the Lewis's. Holding the scepter, holding the rod, you know. It's no way around none of it. That's why he's the Puff Daddy, because the daddy just goes into the whole theme of the Father and the Son are one. And that Puff, because that just goes into that whole theme, you know, of the cloud gathering. As it's written, I come with a great cloud. You go into Hebrews 12:1, it says what? That the cloud is the witnesses who witness that the Messiah returned, man. It's all about paying attention to the signs. So let's keep this thing going about more about that library. I'm going to delve deeper into this. So you see that whole theme is very important, because you see this whole theme dealing with the library. This is 2018 and the library shut down. You know? So the library shut down in 2018. So let's go to 2018. You see how that whole theme of the museum, the library ordeal. So you see, look at this. Notice who's in there. You know, Killmonger looking at all the artifacts. You know, they call it Nigeria, but in reality, that's Judah, which I'll show later on in the video. You know, but you see how he's in there looking at the glass, because, you know, as it's written in 1 Corinthians 13:12, that the Messiah is revealed through the glass. That's why they used to say Candyman, you say his name 5 times and he shall appear. You call upon the Lord and he shall appear. You know, as it's written, the whole theme about the bees, because he leads us to the land of milk and honey, you know, the Candyman. I broke that down before too, but let's just stay on topic with this. See this.
For real? And what about this one?
I beg your pardon.
It was taken by British soldiers in Benin, but it's from Wakanda, and it's made out of vibranium. Don't trip. I'm gonna take it off your hands for you.
These items aren't for sale.
You see that right there? Coming to take that library. You see that? So all that stuff coming together. You know how the whole thing, how he goes into the museum, goes into the library. You see that? So let's delve. It's all a step-by-step process. Let's delve deeper into this. Same thing here. Now in Revelation 13, as it's written that the leopard, you know, the mixed leopard is the Antichrist. So, you know, the panther is a leopard without spots. So, you know, T'Challa just represents Obama. And the Killmonger represents Messiah. So you see how they show the apartments that T'Challa buys. You see he go to Killmonger's apartments. And you see how he buys the apartments. So you see.
Dink.
And that's a big dink. And that one over there. This will be the first Wakanda International Outreach Center. Nakia will oversee the social outreach. You will spearhead the science and information exchange.
See that? There go the library again. We're going to turn this into a library to teach the people. You see? But look at their plan. You know, this is all their imaginations. Remember, Killmonger already cast him down because, as it's written, the Antichrist will be thrown off the altar in Isaiah 14, that he shall be cast down. You know? By the Messiah as time progresses once the exit does happen. But you see how in their imagination, you know, they can say we kill Killmonger, you know. But you see how they wanted to see people. But notice you got the church right by the UFO, because they wanted to see people with how the Messiah comes from the sky, and that's how it's going to happen. You see, that's going to be the Christ line that's going to try to keep people looping in the Messiah. Well, you know, rapture everybody up. I got all the videos on that I broke down. But you see, they got to have it by the church. You see? And you see how they got that Toyota Corolla over there? Because that Corolla just goes to the Carol. You see how all the children are deceived. But that's just how they're trying to deceive the children of God into looking back to the sky. You know? Let's read Acts 1:11 again, if you don't mind me talking. You know, 1:11. In which also ye said, men of Galilee, why stand ye gazing up into heaven? This same Yahushua, which is taking you up from heaven into heaven, shall come in like as the manner as you see him go into heaven. So you see how they're trying to deceive the people. That's just what their imagination is. Let's hear more talk. You see how I said that the Messiah was going to meet up with the mayors, which happened twice this year. Look at this.
Call me a menace. I just sat with the mayor and politicians. I'm trying to change the image.
See that they all channel, and that's why he around all the children, because they want to just war against the children of God, you know. So let's hear what that J. Cole devil got to say. Let's hear what he talking about. You see, I ran with the mayors and the politicians. I'm trying to change the image. No, place would hurt themselves, you know. I know some kids want to hurt themselves, cause, you know, that's how they want us to hurt ourselves, lose our path. Listen to this devil. They not your friends, man. Hear what he say.
I've been stuck between maybe retiring and feeling like.
Oh, no, shut up. I ain't trying to hear all that.
Somebody murder little buddy.
See that? I don't even know little buddy. To somebody murder little buddy. Because as it's written, the Messiah will bud. So they don't want people knowing who he on the earth. You see what I'm saying? They want all the children, you know, outside the house of the Lord, you know. Don't be in the house of God. Dwell outside the house of God. Just listen to us. Antichrist is talk. Nobody knew little buddy until somebody murdered little buddy, you know.
I'm on the phone searching little buddy name.
Now I'm on the phone searching little buddy name. That go right back to that Wichita song. You know, I'm going to say, no one to hear about it. You know, everybody know about it. From the Queen of England to the House of Hell. You know, that's what they doing. That's what they're saying.
Got a playing his tunes all day in my room.
So J. Cole said, got him playing tunes all day in my room, because basically he let you, like I broke it down before, they just fallen angels. As you can see, the little boy in the orange, super MK Ultra. A lot of these are just MK Ultra, you know, assets, you know. But you hear J. Cole talking about, you know, I got to hear all his tunes all day in my room, because he let you know he was a fallen. They didn't want to sing the songs of the Lord. They want to sing Hallelujah, Lewis, Eternal, Amen. They wanted to follow Lucifer and sing their own songs. So you see, that's what J. Cole is letting you know, that he already heard it in heaven. So now he on earth and he got to hear about him all day, hearing his name spreading through the phone, through the cloud, people waking up.
Thinking, damn, this shit wicked to get their names buzzing. Some niggas just got to go lay in a tomb.
See, look. Thinking this is wicked to get their name buzzing for some N-word just to go lay in a tomb. You hear that? So get his name buzzing so he can go lay in a tomb. You see, because he already know the Messiah got to go inside that king's chamber of the altar with the Ark of the Covenant. So you see what he's saying? Get their name buzzing, you know?
And media thirsty for clicks. I got a new rule. If you ain't ever posted a rapper when he was alive, you can't post about him after he get hit.
See, that whole thing, they don't want people knowing about them. You know, that rapper stuff just goes to how they're embalming, dealing with the christening. You know, to prepare to go inside the tomb, inside the king's chamber. Let's delve even deeper into this right quick. Listen to this.
Cause all she ever talk about is Louis, Louis. All she ever talk about is Louis Vuitton.
Hear that? Louis, Louis, all she ever talk about is Louis. You know, listen to this right here. It's very significant because that law is coming, you know, from Zion. So, you know, he's talking about weapons and swords and guns and everything. But in reality, it's all just symbolic of the, as it's written, the word of God is as a mighty sword, you know. That's why Hosea 1:7 said, you know, the Messiah is not going to defend us or free us via warfare. He's going to use what? He's going to use truth and knowledge and understanding. He's not going to use war. That's why the prophecy says they'll beat their weapons into war, into plowshares. That's why they already have it where it's gun control coming. You know, everything going to start magnifying if people don't know what's going on, man. So hear this.
We're going to send vibranium weapons out to our war dogs. They'll arm oppressed people all over the world, so they can finally rise up and kill those in power and their children and anyone else who takes their side.
See that? So basically how we gonna overpower Satan's kingdom. You know, the children he's talking about is the Masons, those who work hand in hand. You know, Satan is the father of lies. Those who inherited, made pact with the devil, who made oath to serve Lucifer are gonna be slain. You know, spiritually, physically too, but spiritually, you know.
It's time they know the truth about us. We're warriors.
Hear that? They know the truth about us. We're warriors, because Lewis just means the warrior. We're the Lewis's is what he's saying.
The world's going to start over, and this time we're on top.
You see that? This time we're on top. The world's going to start over. Remember, Liu Kang on a new Mortal Kombat just started the universe over. Remember, he just started the whole Mortal Kombat universe over with a clean slate. You see? That's why everybody who's coming into the universe as a DLC, they're like, they coming to try to battle Liu Kang. Remember, I put that in videos. Omni-Man beating him up on a train. You know what I mean? And all of that stuff, because that all goes into how they already know they want to prevent the Exodus, you know.
The sun will never set on the Wakandan Empire.
The sun, the light of God, the son of God, you know.
Wakanda has survived for so long by fighting when only absolutely necessary.
Wakanda survived in the past this way, yes. But the world is changing, General. Elders, it is.
Yeah, he said the elders, because that just goes to the elders of Zion. So you, you hear how he said, but the world is changing, General. You know?
It's getting smaller. The outside world is catching up. And soon, it will be the conquerors or the conquered.
So he's flowing, the mind of Christ is flowing through him. So he's agreeing with Killmonger. Like, yo, yeah, yes, sir, you speaking the truth, you know? So let's delve even deeper. Pay attention to who he is. Notice he got the blue on as well, because they know that all goes into Judah, the law, the order, you know? Let's delve deeper into this. For guys, wanted to show that right quick, the whole theme of the law and order, you know? Let's go into this, the priesthood. So hint the whole theme of the library, the recreation center. You kind of see what I mean? So notice how the guy who's on Black Panther, Daniel, who's working hand-in-hand with Killmonger, notice he's on Widows. Notice he's in the gymnasium. All right, you're right to the point.
I caught the niggas in the back rapping.
Excuse the language.
Hey, man, it wasn't our fault.
Yo, I say, what the fuck is up?
Use the language. But notice how they doing that rap. You see that rapping. They want to be their own rappers, be their own gods. So you see how he's in here. He's listening to them rap. You see that inside the gymnasium. So pay attention.
My script, get it. Yo.
All right.
Get your humble up. Buckle up. Man, I do it for my guys. If you diss, then you gotta die. That's a simple fact, simple truth. I could never lie. Dios mio, man. From the same spot.
See that whole thing, that war he's talking about, Killmonger is talking about. All that black identity, they gonna know who we are. They ain't gonna be looking at us as some rappers. We're the real rappers, you know? So you see how all that stuff is in the gymnasium, the library. You kind of see what I mean? That's why even a few days ago, right before September 23rd happened, notice why Kyrie, Jalen Brunson, when have you ever seen somebody wearing Wichita State? Notice why they all in there in the rec center, hint the community rec center. You know, it's a private gym, but I'm just saying it's still a whole ideal of a rec, of a gym. So notice all that stuff dealing with the Wichita State. You see, there's no way around none of this. It's just like a few days before that happened. So pay attention to this. It's all coming to fruition. The Exodus is unraveling. As it's written in Numbers 24:8, God brought him forth out of Egypt. He have, as it were, the strength of a unicorn. So you see the strength of a unicorn. A unicorn is really the rhino. So that's why you see on the movie, you see the Daniel was riding on that rhino. The guy who was working hand in hand with Killmonger. You see, look.
Drop your weapon.
You see that? So that you remember on Wakanda, remember Wakanda was a dome. Remember? So Wakanda was inside of like a dome, like a glass dome. So you know, as it's written in scriptures in Exodus 34:19, you know. For God, you know, that's the whole theme of ye who come out of the matrix are mine. So you know who come out the matrix are of the Father. So that's why Wakanda was inside that dome. That's why they was fighting so hard, because they don't want the Exodus to happen. See? But it is, but I'm just showing y'all symbology. All this is 2018. So let's look at Sektor on Mortal Kombat. Yeah, she become the rhino and kill the sorcerer. See that? She become the rhino and slay the sorcerer. You know? That's why Yo Gotti in 2015 had the passport called The Return, his mixtape The Return. Because they know what was happening in 2015. They know the Messiah was within Kenya. Because Kenya is where the true Mount Zion is, the holy mountain. And then, you know, you got, Israel, Zion, which is the altars. So you see all that area. Then Kenya is where the holy mountain, Mount Kenya. That's why at the top of Mount Kenya is the Lewis Glacier. So you see Lewis was out of Kansas State, and he was in the country since 2013. This right here is 2015, July 8th. You know, the Messiah born July 5th, this July 8th. And, Barack Obama was there. What, like 15 days, like 20 days later almost? And he was talking about, I'm the first Kenyan American to be president. And he was over there talking about how, you know, so-called rights, you know, sodomite rights, you know, the LGBT rights should be spread around the country. You know, the Antichrist. So you see, even when Lewis, you know, when the Messiah was in Kenya and he was in the court, you see, he said that he'd rather be in Kenyan prison than live in bondage. What did Killmonger say? And this is 3 years after. So, you know, they channel. What did Killmonger say 3 years later on the Black Panther movie? Remember, he said he'd rather be buried at sea than go and be in, you know, than be in bondage, you know, because he know death is better than bondage. All the same thing, just mocking, you know, he blaspheme all day. That's why the same day, right before the meeting, on September 23rd, which was Monday, so on the 22nd, you had the Commanders battling the Bengals, because the Commanders, remember, they used to go by Redskins. So that just show how we, Judah, overcoming the black identity, the false identity, you know? And that's why they play in D.C., because that deals with the law anyway. And then, you know, I brought up the Killmonger because around that time, too, the same day, you had what? Jaguars playing the Bills. Remember, Killmonger wasn't a Panther. He was a Jaguar, you know? And he played against the Bills. You know, Bill is just short for William, which is the I am. So they already knew what was about to happen anyway. And then you had the Bengals, because the Bengals just go into the eye of the tiger. You know, the Messiah on the prowl. You know what I'm saying? That's why, you remember, let me show you. People not really familiar. So look, you see how you got the Detroit Tiger logo. You know, I remember seeing this growing up in Detroit, obviously. But you see, you got that Detroit Tiger. You see, you got that tiger coming through the D, because in the Hebrew, that just represents the doorway. So the Messiah coming through the door. You know, Messiah got that key, as I was speaking about. The Lewis key, the key of David, to open the doors and shutteth, and no man openeth, as it's written in Revelation 3:7. So you see, like I was telling y'all earlier about the Nigeria, was really the land of Judah. You know, that was really the coast, the Judah coast. You know, they changed the name. You know, you had that lady Flora Louise. Notice her name got to be Lewis Louise. Flora Louise Shaw is the one who created the name Nigeria, because Nigeria just means to be black. So, you know, they wanted to hide the name, make us blacks. As it's written in Psalms 83, verse 4, they have said, come and let us cut them off from being a nation, that the name of Israel may be remembered no more. You see? So that's why she changed it to Nigeria. You know? Satan already, the only president to go inside the altars is Obama, the Antichrist. You know? Because as it's written, who opposeth and exalteth himself above all that is called God or that is worshipped, so that he is God, sitteth in the temple of God, showing himself that he is God. So that's why he had to go inside the altars. They already know the Exodus is about to fulfill, and it's going to be by the plains. That's why it says, then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. So shall we forever be with the Lord. So that's what they already know. The plain Exodus is about to fulfill. That's why right now, like I said before, when you understand how blasphemy works, blasphemy let you know what time you're in. That's why you're hearing a lot of malfunctions with planes right now, because they know the time of the saints getting on the planes is near. So you see, when Killmonger was battling T'Challa, remember, Killmonger already king. Notice how T'Challa, you see how he crashed the plane. They want to crash the plane. They don't want the Exodus to happen. Same as them stopping the unicorn. And they remember he screamed, I am not dead. You know? They don't want the Exodus to happen. So let's delve even deeper into this before this video concludes, man. So hint, the homelander, they want us to stay in, no Exodus, stay here. No Exodus, no home, no Exodus. Just stay landed here in Babylon. Here it is, spiritual Babylon. Look at this. All in our face. You know, it's all about who got the eyes to see it. You see the people screaming on the plane.
Fatality. Homelander wins.
You see that? No exodus. They want to crash the plane because they know that's why 9/11, you know, had to happen. Because when you understand the 9/11 was the two towers. And when you understand about Freemasonry, you got the two Masonic pillars. So the exodus of the plane is all symbolic. When we exodus and we are on the plains, that brings down their Masonic kingdom. That's what it all was really standing for. That's why they had to amp up their security, you know, using the X-ray. Because they don't want, you know, the X-ray, the X is just the symbol of Christ anyway, the Christos. So they want an X-ray. They want to make sure there's no... They want to X out Ray. You know, Ray is Ra'el. So Ray is just short for Ra. It is Ra'el. Ra means the light. So they want to X that out. They don't want no exodus. They want to make sure they scan and make sure you have no way out, you know. Watch your belongings. Make sure you don't got the word of God, the sword on you, you know. Or you can't travel. That's why Green Day even had that song, you know, Wake Me Up When September Ends, because he already know September was coming. The Messiah was going to have a meeting. They already know this is the beginning of the end for them. They work years ahead of time. They don't work in our time. They work years ahead of time. They know the word. They know the script. And they know what's going to be done. That's why T'Challa's girlfriend was Lupita. And you know Lupita, remember she is just on that Quiet Place, the prequel movie that came out this year. Because they know that time of them being silent is coming. Being silent before the Lord. You know, the law is coming. They ain't going to have that freedom of speech stuff soon. That's why Earth, Wind, and Fire had that. Do you remember, you know, the 21st day of September, you know. We're dancing the night away, you know. They know what's coming, man. Same with the Temptations. Remember they had that song, The Papa Was a Rolling Stone, and he said, you know, it was the 3rd of September, the day I always remember, you know. So all that stuff comes into fruition. Even that show, I was talking about earlier, The Welcome Back Kotter, that premiered 1975 September, you know. So they already knew it was coming anyway, you know. So all that stuff comes together. It's all about paying attention to the signs, you know. See that it started September 9th, you know, and they call it the Great Debate. You see, the first episode was the Great Debate. So they already know that debate, that whole theme of that clash between the Messiah and the Antichrist is coming. So it's no way around none of this, you know. So I'm gonna stop this video right here. Thank you for watching Hide and Seek TV. Much more is coming, man. Peace.